fly.
No one in that group that really compares to you or me at all.
Good surf, Carl. Let's go.
How well the drop shot part, double mount. I have to. It's not as what it used to be, because I haven't had to practice with it, but you need it. I got the drop of the blocks on the table, though.
No, I mean, you just let me do the double bounce, and then I did a little trick that you could do a lot of
it. Ball part. And the first game, you got me on it, because I was like, well, that curve was more than I thought it was.
Yeah, I'm a much more patient. It was really very good.
I was so jittery that first game. I was like, oh, shit, this continues. He's gonna live it free me, live it to me.
Well, it's Scott's advice was like, in between your serves, I was like, that's gonna change. You're gonna get used to it. I said, I don't think so. I was like, wishful thinking.
It's like, the 2000 the second, level, man. They all do that.
Yeah. And then after the second game, I was like, you choked. I said, yes.
Actually, the one I think you really choked on, even though you fell, was the third game.
Well, I was up 7-6.
You were up 10-6. And then I caught up 10. I figured since it was 10-8 my serve, I knew if I could take your serve, I could maybe rush you on my serve and pull some bullshit points.
I was thinking about it too, and I'm like,
my serve, you should have been like,
yeah, I'm like, early, I can pull this out. Later. And later.
What is your rating now? 1904. But I just,
that's good.
The last tournament I played, I was 950, so that's, I 10-0 the bracket. So I'm hoping next tournament I'll go for 2000.
He won't hold this
one. I still don't feel like the 1900. Well, not most of them. Yeah. Some of them belong to like 21, 22. But me and AJ, Dodge, and Matthew Delgado, we're going to Columbia for the.
Oh, you're going to Columbia.
Saving, so they're coming to our division this weekend as a guest, but they've been called
they're the closest team. This is the way I thought. They're the closest team to Orlando.
No. I completely agree with your decision on this. They shouldn't be allowed to grant some of the NCAA.
I know. But it is a sucky deal. So the way it works is University of Miami and Stetson are on the periphery in that division. They pay. Whether or not they show up, Miami does it every year. Stetson's a random school. Now, if one of them shows up, the division is legal. Florida State in that division. It's legal.
Even with all of that, they're charging school, so they should still be legal.
Well, still
in the paper.
We're giving them that permission.
Okay, so you're still allowing Florida in here. But what about UCF or USC? Are they allowed to pay?
If the division falls, they are allowed in. If not, the division stands as is. Not just the UNL, but the UNL, the UNL, the UNL, the UNL. So, meaning they've been feeling like a little match.
And it's not gonna include any of you, but it's like for your name, but I am guessing that's what it is. The school should not be able to hold grants anymore. If they don't want to flat, they shouldn't be allowed to play.
Flat holding grants.
Yeah, they were saying we don't want to know. What they're doing is they have three teams and they think they're so fucking good that they want to go out and do it. And they know what those three teams are.
They all need three teams in the next.
Well, USF and UCF are a national team. I'll admit that. They have 2,100.
But in general, we have another rule. If a division falls,